5 on Your Health this morning. America's top doctor sounding the alarm about the link between alcohol and cancer and calling for alcohol to come with a warning label like cigarettes.
The Surgeon General says drinking just one glass a day increases your risk of cancer. Here to explain is Dr. Aimin Lee, an epidemiologist in the Division of Preventative Medicine at Brigham and Women's Hospital. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
Well, you've read this report from the U.S. Surgeon General. He wants to add a cancer warning to bottles of alcohol. But is the risk really the same here?
So the answer to your question is the risk between alcohol and smoking the same. It's a little bit complicated. So the answer is it depends. The Surgeon General's advisory yesterday was on alcohol and specifically cancer. But cancer is not a single disease. There's actually many different diseases. For example, if you think about breast cancer, it's not the same as obviously prostate cancer. The literature clearly links drinking to 7 specific types of cancer, one of which is breast cancer, the most commonly occurring cancer in women. Women who drink one drink a day have about a 10% increased risk of breast cancer. The more you drink, the higher your risk. Women who smoke one pack of cigarettes a day have about an equivalent increased risk of breast cancer. So for breast cancer, it looks like alcohol and smoking are perhaps the same order of magnitude. But if you think about lung cancer, smoking increases the risk of lung cancer tremendously by almost tenfold. But the literature does not suggest that there's a link between alcohol and lung cancer. So for lung cancer, the risk is not equivalent. I think the point of the advisory is not so much to say, okay, which is more evil, I'll do the less evil one, but to raise our awareness that drinking does come with health risks. Most of us know that smoking is associated with cancer. If you go out on the street and poll a random person, 9 out of 10 people will know that smoking increases your risk of cancer, but fewer than half the public knows that alcohol is associated with cancer. So I think one of the goals of the advisory is just to increase awareness that drinking is not totally harmless.
Doctor, I think a lot of people were so shocked when this was released on Friday. So on the list of priorities for living longer, where do you place alcohol consumption?
I would say that I don't just want to live longer. I want to live longer and have good quality of life as well. So in order to do that, I think 3 very important things are: don't smoke, be physically active, eat a healthy diet. In addition, it's also important to have adequate sleep, manage your stress, and to drink sparingly, if at all. Doing these things will add years to our life and life to our years.
Okay. Good advice. Dr. Aimin Lee, an epidemiologist in the Division of Preventative Medicine at Brigham and Women's Hospital, thank you so much for joining us and thank you for the advice this morning.
Thank you.